So that basically starts us wanting to rethink some of the ideas we've had about lenses and defocus things. Let me review some of that just to kind of get us started, because then we're actually going to look at how we're going to change these things. Of course, remember that basically what we have when we have a lens like this, we have an aperture, the opening, right? The opening is the amount of the area that actually goes through the aperture and then hits the sensor after the shutter is open. Shutter is the one that controls the amount of time, the aperture, the amount of light that enters. Now, if you recall some of the simple optic stuff, we'd looked at this before. There's also always a sensor, there's a lens, and the light, of course, from the focal plane goes through. And if you put the object on the focal plane, what basically happens is the image is formed on the camera sensor, and that's exactly, we get a focused image. And of course, the image of the point light source, if there was a point light source at this point here where the object is, we would basically get something like this. And of course, the point spread function would just be a sharp line like this. So of course, this is inverted. The white bright one basically shows this is my point spread function here for this region. This is the optics we have looked at many a times in this class. Now let's actually start thinking about what defocus does in the context of this simple lens system, which basically means now is I'm going to move the object at a different distance. So the same light source from here would now basically mean that the actual convergence of this light is happening a little bit ahead. This is where my camera sensor, so of course it's now getting to be a little bit, forming a little bit before this location. And of course, there's now divergence showing up, which then results in a point spread function that's much thicker. And of course, that translates into the image of the defocus point light source would look something like this, much wider as shown here. Let's move the object further back. Of course, when we do this, you can notice that the point spread function gets wider. And of course, we also know that would mean that the image of the defocused point light source would look bigger. Just to kind of continue this exercise, we will actually now do the last one, where we basically move this further away, and you know this is even wider. And of course, bigger blob is showing up here, and it's a defocused point light source, which is point here. So we know about this kind of stuff, and that gives us a little bit of an idea of how all of this works, something we had looked at before. Another further example of this is it gets bigger. And here now I'm showing you the last stage where I've moved the object further. And of course, the point spread function is really wide and the defocus point light source is also much larger.